Understanding U.S. Treasury Bills. One way the U.S. government raises money is through the sale of U.S. Treasury bills, often referred to as T-bills. Essentially, the buyer of one of these Treasury bills is acting as a loan officer or banking institution and lending money to good old Uncle Sam. T-bills do not pay any interest. Instead, they are sold as a discount note and thus earn money by selling at face value upon maturity. T-bills use discount interest because of the fact that they're discounted, and what makes it a T-bill is that it is a very short loan with lengths of 3 months, 6 months, and a maximum of 1 year. There are other ways that the government raises money through notes and bonds and so on. T-bills are usually issued in the following denominations: $1,000 up to $1 million. The T-bills, as well as all other treasuries, are considered to be very safe, actually the safest, because of the fact that the U.S. government backs them. And, good news, any interest or earnings from the buyer of these notes or bills are exempt from state and local taxes. So let's take a look at an example. You decide to loan $1,000 to the U.S. government, and you do that through the purchase of a one-year T-bill. It has a face value of $1,000 with a discount rate of 2%. T-bills are treated as though they were discount notes, and so the following questions are being asked. Find the discount, find the purchase price, and find the amount the United States government eventually will pay back to you at the maturity date. So to calculate the bank discount or the cost of this loan, we take maturity value, the $1,000 or face value, times the discount rate of 2%, times the time in terms of years, which is 1, gives us a bank discount of $20. That means the purchase price that we pay to the U.S. government is the proceeds. The face value of this treasury bill is $1,000. It's discounted, and so the U.S. government only has the use of the proceeds, $980, and that is our purchase price that we give to the government to go ahead and use as a loan. What will the U.S. pay when 1 year has transpired? They will pay the maturity value. The government for a year had the use of $980 of this $1,000 face value T-bill, and at the end of the year they will pay back their proceeds, $980, plus that bank discount or the cost of this loan, giving us the maturity value of $1,000. We have a second example here. A Japanese investment firm purchases $25 million in U.S. T-bills at a 6% discount for 13 weeks. We have a series of requests here. Find the purchase price or proceeds, and so on. Let's take a look at the first one, the purchase price. And again, you have to put yourself in the position of how the United States is actually the borrower, and in this case the Japanese investment firm is the banking institution or the lender. So what will the proceeds, which ultimately means the purchase price for this Japanese investment firm, is found by taking the maturity value minus the bank discount, which we don't know, so we'll need to calculate that. So what we've done is replaced B with the equivalent, maturity value times discount rate times time, replaced those variables with the specific values, which gave us the purchase price. A Japanese investment firm paid out $24,625,000 as proceeds for the U.S. government to use for the next 13 weeks. The second question asks us, what is the maturity value of this T-bill? That is the face value. So in 13 weeks, after the U.S. government had use of less than $25 million, they will pay back to the Japanese investment firm $25 million. The next question is asking us, what is the interest earned in terms of the Japanese investment? We can find this one of two ways. We can take our maturity value minus our proceeds will give us our bank discount, or we can use the formula to determine the bank discount, which was built into the first part of this problem. In either case, it's $375,000. From the United States standpoint, as the borrower, that was their cost of borrowing $25 million. And for the Japanese investor, acting as the lender, this is their interest earned. What is the effective rate? We'll use our formula, bank discount divided by proceeds times time. Here we have it listed with the particulars. The bank discount, $375,000, divided by the quantity, proceeds times the time, and because this is weeks, we express it over 52 to have our time in terms of years. We have a decimal value of 0.0609, which is equivalent to 6.09%.